Hello, I am Chad Lewis, pastor, teacher, and author, and this is another edition of the Mr. Lewis mini lecture. Today's topic, the obscure subject of ritual purity in the book of Leviticus. Now, for many people who study their Old Testament, the book of Leviticus is a mystery. It's many people's least favorite book of the Bible, one of my most favorite, but it contains all kinds of rituals, the meaning of which a lot of people do not understand, a great many of them involving washing with water for anything involving death or leprosy or sex. And many people wonder, what was the rationale behind these laws? Why did the Jews keep them? And why do Christians not keep them today? And for starters, I will say that all of these laws have to do with a subject called ritual purity. Ritual purity was not something unknown in the ancient Near East. Other temples had it too. And the idea is this, that before a person goes to temple to offer sacrifice or whatever it is that they need to do, they must be in a state of ritual purity. In other words, they can't just walk in one fine day whenever they want. Just as your mother won't let you come in the house to dinner if you're covered with dirt, so ritual purity laws govern what people what condition they must be in before they approach the temple for worship. Now, in the book of Leviticus, there are three conditions under which a person cannot approach the temple. One is if they've come into contact with a dead body, a corpse. Two, if their body is in a state of decay, a condition the Hebrew text called zara'at, usually translated leprosy, which is most certainly a mistranslation. Their body is in a state of decay. Or third, any loss of vital fluids, so menstrual fluids if the person is a woman, or seminal fluids if the person is a man. Anybody who has come into contact with a corpse, their body's in a state of decay, or they lost vital fluids recently, must wash with water and wait for a period of time, depending on the severity of the impurity, before they go to the temple. I'd say, well, why all the fuss about corpses, bodily fluids, and decay? Well, Yahweh, the God of Israel, is life. And all of these things, once you think about them, are sources of death. The dead corpse, the decay of the flesh, or vital fluids, which in the case of the egg, or in the case of the seed, die when they leave the body. So the purpose here is that the person must not bring anything associated with death into the sanctuary of Yahweh. They must wait and wash with water before they are fit to enter. I would sometimes wonder why Christians do not observe these laws, but it's important to note that they play a very big role in the New Testament. If we look at the miracles that Jesus performed, what does he do? He often raises the dead to life. He often heals lepers. And there are stories, of course, of the woman with a loss of blood, which lasted for 12 years. So these stories in the book of Leviticus are not foreign to the New Testament. And it's clear that the writers of the Gospels felt that Jesus had power over death, and that a big part of his ministry was not just the forgiveness of sin, but also the liberation of man from the forces of death. Now it's starting to rain, so it looks like I'm going to get a ritual washing out here, but a few comments. Christians do not observe these laws in the first place because these laws are not moral laws. There are laws about proper observance in the temple. In the second place, Christian belief in the resurrection of Jesus from the dead, the resurrection of all who put their faith in him, means that they are liberated from the powers of death. And so it's not that God made up a special set of rules one day and then decided to change them, but rather the satisfaction of these purity rituals has been made for those who put their faith in Christ. If you have any more interest in ritual purity laws of the Torah, specifically the book of Leviticus, I recommend you read Jacob Milgram's wonderful commentary on Leviticus, study the other civilizations of the ancient Near East, and compare the ritual purity laws that they had for their temples. Remember, you can listen to my sermons for free online at newtemplec.com. For all you readers out there, buy my book, Norman's Descent, on Amazon or Barnes & Noble. Till then, my fellow travelers, Pax Tibi and God bless.